50 years navigating life's unpredictable circumstances was anchored for me while I was listening to a powerful message delivered by Reverend Gregory J. Boyles of Homeboy Industries. His affirming words caused me to rest firmly in knowing that only the soul who ventilates the world with tenderness has any real chance of changing it. Amen, Reverend. Amen. And so I do, even when I don't want to. And there are plenty of those days. But with resolute intention, I rest firmly and choose to show up with tenderness and lead with compassion in all arenas of my life, both personal and professional. In my life's darkest moments, I learn the all-important lesson that courage is not a feeling. Courage is a choice available to everyone, right now, right where we are, regardless of whatever is staring us down and whatever demons we need to face. I know now more than ever, through the experience of authoring this book, that it takes gallons of courage and a wholehearted commitment to show up as the best, truest, most vulnerable version of ourselves. And I also know that in doing so, the best of ourselves becomes accessible to everyone else, including our children, and we all grow better together. Quite a few people have asked me how the idea for You Don't Have to Crush Your Ex came about. The truth is, the idea of writing a book had called to me since age 7, when I submitted a short story to a contest at the local summertime fair. In that moment, 42 years ago, a conscious decision was made to author a book one day. What book was never clear, not the topic or purpose or the impact I wanted my message to make on a particular audience. I simply wanted to write a book, put my name on the front cover, and have a tangible legacy that would collect dust on bookstore shelves, mostly to satisfy my ego and say that I did it. Fast forward to today, and I'm steeped in pride to know that I did do it. I created a book that will do a lot more than just collect dust. My ego is satisfied, and I'm confident that my message leads with tenderness, kindness, and compassion for parents and for children, hopefully inspiring the awareness that we really all are just walking each other home. I'm beyond grateful for the privilege of being a trusted child advocate in my community and for the opportunity to minister as a professional who cares deeply about preserving the fabric of the entire family system